The Uganda Bus Owners Association has decried the gradual reduction in the number of operating buses. Due to the effects of COVID-19 and intermittent hikes in spare parts prices, some operators have progressively failed to get into business operations again. The bus owners' leadership has highlighted that they are strained by the different taxes they are subjected to.
Before COVID, we had around 1,000 buses operating here in Uganda. Currently, we have around 600 buses. So the numbers have gone down due to the COVID effects, which have affected even other sectors. But two, the taxation and the increase in fuel prices, increase in spare parts.
Leaders of the Uganda Bus Owners Association have further asked the government to fix the dilapidated roads in the city as they affect flow of traffic.
In my own perspective on the issue of congestion, the long term is to make the roads wider, which I don't know the government can do. And even not wider, but the quality of the roads here in Kampala, because of the potholes, even when the roads are small, but if they were like smooth and good, the vehicles would move. But there are roads where the potholes are also delaying the buses.
While issuing guidelines aimed at ensuring safety of road users ahead of the festive season, the Commissioner of Transport Regulation and Safety in the Ministry of Works and Transport, Winston Katshabe, cautioned all drivers against drunk driving. It was also revealed that plans are underway to start taking blood samples in a bid to detect drivers who drive under alcohol and drug influence.
Our research recently established that most of the drivers for big buses take alcohol during the night and drive during morning, and which is very dangerous to our passengers.
The association has welcomed this move on grounds that it will not only save people's lives, but also give a firm account for safety on roads, especially during the festive season.
When they park the buses at night and they go to their homes or to their places of rest, we don't know what exactly they do in the night. And we can only see them in the morning. Unfortunately, some of them drink during the night, and at times they are not even aware that they have taken alcohol. Sometimes the content is too little for us to detect.
Traffic police, as you know, all our buses are checked at various points, checkpoints as on major highways. So if they're going to add in that extra check, it is welcome. It will go, I think, in a long way in ensuring safety of our passengers.
Information from a bus operators association suggests that at least 44,850 people use buses every day to different parts of the country and across borders. That figure represents the maximum number of 65 people who are believed to board each of the 690 buses which operate from or within Uganda daily. The association has revealed that the transport will undoubtedly increase from the 21st this month because the number of people coming to Kampala is expected to reduce a lot. Derek Asaba, reporting for the news.